lastly, if I may, how many drop curbs are you talking about in at that location you're thinking of?
We've only got the one, I think, that we can lay. We're not greedy.
This guy.
Well, we are. That's a big crossing. It's all the roads and the way, as you know. And that's coming up to reach 200,000. Obviously, we're acceptable. We'd like to keep that. I mean, don't want that to disappear from your consciousness. So, we'd like to.
So, you're not putting that forward as
well? No, surprisingly. What I do want you to do there, yeah, so it's just the corner of Marlow over the bridge. That's what.
If I may, I know we've been asked to look at speed indicator device on that corner, but it may be possible to do some minor engineering works which would physically slow vehicles down there. That would probably cost 10, maybe £12,000. Which is slightly more than we've indicated in the programme at the moment. But I'm just going to be back here with what you suggested, the 7,000. So, for accounting purposes, I'm not quite sure whether it is managed to make a financial decision as to whether you'd like to allocate £10,000.
If members are agreeable, it would be best to vote for a scheme to be put in place there that is the most cost-effective but also sustainable, because clearly if it's a physical improvement that can be put in, day presumably that is something you just done your shins, just something that is presumably going to take less investment in the future than the signage, is that
yeah, the signage, it's electronic signage, it may have a lifespan. Curbs and bricks and mortar, sadly, under our home maintenance code, to continue to maintain. So, yes, it will be on there.
Is that it, Jeanette?
Yes.
Okay, Christine told me to put forward that. Okay, for Luke Brighton, basically, in the DSD folder, as the officer, that's the Careville Council, Seaman, Cornwall, North Kingston. There's the Rosen Street, speed indicator device, and the Seaman speed indicator device.
You're
going to
the tape motion?
Okay, and
take out the right, see back over to the
Yeah. Okay, we need to prepare. So you can remove the speed and the device on C back road. And that would leave us the change to the
3,000.
How much?
3,000 pounds
service.
That means that 3,000 pounds, 4,000 pounds average, and we're giving up 7 pounds.
What I was suggesting is that anyone and anyone's proposal will say that that is about 2,000 pounds.
Well, that's true. I think we've got extra two or three that we can maybe give that up. I think the same one that's going to the school.
That will be very helpful for that scheme with only very loosely thought of that addition. Well, it was the current model.
Well, and then you said you could do a little bit of a machine, but you know,
to build that out, it would be helpful to fall back on that. And as I could say, that if we have a shortfall in any of the funding, we will come back to it and let you know. But as time marches on, the ability for us to construct things within the time frames is always a pressure. We're looking for more simpler schemes such as drop curves and so forth in the future. I'm sure you've got recommendations that we can draw up for that should there be an issue. Thank you.
Okay, so we can all agree to fund the project as a matter of order then. Agreed?
Agreed.
I'm not aware of any other business. Ed, on behalf of the Zoe, I'd like to thank Richard Knight, who volunteered to come along with me as well. Thank you very much. Nice, our call is to a close. Thank you all. Thank you.